Okay, this is Ronson Originals, Ronson Monroe McDowell, and I'm here with a lovely young lady. Actually, this is the first person that I will be interviewing today. Tell everyone what your name is.
Hello, my name is Alicia Smith.
And how are you connected with this fashion show today?
Well, I am currently the model coordinator of Embrace That Curse.
All right, so everyone needs to know what your name is and how can they get in touch with you?
Yes, my name is Alicia Smith, and you can find me on Instagram at ansmith1920, or you can email me at etmalicia1920. Thank you.
Now the atmosphere is on fire.
Yes.
And people are... They was lined up when I came, and I came very early.
Yes, they were lined up.
So tell us about the atmosphere. Tell us about the creator, the models, the stylists, the designers, whatever you want to say.
Yes, I want to start off with the models. The models have been working extra hard. They have been working 2 days a week, sometimes two and a half hours, to come and bring you guys an amazing show. The guests that we have arriving now, they look wonderful. They look beautiful. They came to see these models serve, and we gonna serve them, okay? As far as the atmosphere is beautiful. It's very serene, peaceful, okay, and positive. That's what Embrace That Curse. We want to definitely bring confidence and peace and joy. There's no drama, so definitely that type of atmosphere, peace.
Definitely grown and sexy vibe.
Yes, absolutely.
Now, I love your Tara, and I love your look.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about your design today. It's fabulous.
Thank you. Well, I was actually inspired by Lady Whistledown. Of course, you know, this show is a Renaissance show, so I definitely wanted to embody Lady Whistledown. But tonight, you can call me Lady Curves a lot.
I love it.
Thank you.
Now, you definitely have an amazing personality to match your beauty.
Thank you.
So, final question, where did you learn all of this as far as your personality and the beauty?
Ooh, personality and the beauty. I got the beauty from my mama. But for the personality, honestly, just going around different people, different atmospheres, growing, finding things I like, finding things I don't like. If I want something, going after it and get it, and adjusting, not holding on to anything. So, yeah, definitely going with the flow and be happy, finding that sense of peace.
What are you expecting tonight?
I am expecting for the models to go out. I'm expecting them to hit the runway, hit every pose, hit the markers. I am expecting them to bring you a bomb show.
You did an awesome job.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, so the first person that I saw coming in the door tonight was this young man right here. I was totally blown away by his professionalism and his people skills. Tell us what your name is, sir.
So I'm Willie J, also known as Willie J Starra.
How can they find you on social media? Because they're going to have to connect with you.
Where is Willie J. Starra? WilliejStarrah. Where is Willie J. Starra?
Now, listen, people. I'm going to just let him talk because he got it together. I'm not even going to lie. I was so impressed. I thought that he was a representative for Rihanna or someone, the way he was so professional. Tell us a little bit about what's going on tonight and what you're going to be doing and your title.
So my title is Fashion Show Producer, but I'm co-producer because I got the wonderful Alicia. We've been putting back and forth with it and really putting the show together. So what you can expect tonight is dynamic fashions. We have so many eclectic mix of designers, boutique owners in the space. We have people from Columbus here, you know, so it's really great to see that transition from not just Cleveland-based artists, but they're coming all over. And we have some from Detroit. So there's a really dope designer, Brooks Accessories. She is 4 years old. So I'm excited for that surprise when the audience sees her, because you're not going to expect this is the designer behind these.
Absolutely.
This look. So yeah.
Absolutely. Now, I cannot explain the ambiance and how beautiful it is inside. So could you tell our audience just how magnificent it is inside?
So the theme was Bridgerton. Darcia called and told us about the idea, and then her team, Jazz, Whitney, Ashley, all those young, wonderful ladies came together. It was Whitney's brainchild, and she executed that effortlessly. And it's all about your flowers. It's about the beautiful big backdrops, very avant-garde. So you're more vintage. You're getting the feel of, you know, the 1800s, the 1920s, and beyond. And you really are transformed in that space. So I love what the ladies did. And it's just so dynamic, just like this beautiful backdrop here, too. So, yeah, I am excited to see, you know, what everybody puts together and brings to the table.
Lastly, the energy here. It's just off the top. I just did a walk around real quick, and I was like, oh, my goodness, I got to be on my A game tonight. So Is that something that you all have, the spirit of excellence, where everyone wants to be on their A game?
Yes. Listen, rehearsals have been amazing with everybody, but like I've told them, you know, we walk them through what they can expect, but there's nothing like Showtime when you actually have to experience it in real time. So, you know, when the camera's on, you don't have time to be like, ooh, let me get myself together. You got to go. So now, for me, I'm glad to see the models really get a chance to take that in and be like, oh, I didn't know you had to do this part. Now I get it. It's starting to click. So with that being said, you can expect dynamic everything coming out. And for me, I'm the one sending them off. So that's predominantly my role, keeping the pace of the show going. You got Samantha Walker, who's going to be doing an amazing job with hosting. I'm so excited to be a part of the production with her. I've actually paid to see the productions and watch her host. So now to be able to say we're in company with that, again, for those who want to break into the fashion world, don't be afraid to invest to the spaces and people you want to connect with, because that's how you start.
I know you have a lot to do, and there's a lot of people in line waiting to be interviewed. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for having
me. And have an excellent evening.
You too.
So I'm the host.
Okay,
Samantha.
So are you, come on in closer to me. Are you the one that he was talking about?
I am the one that Willie was referring to. I'm Sam, also known as Curvy, Confident, and Nervous, and tonight I will be the MC.
Now, he put in an awesome plug about you.
Yeah.
So for the people, put a plug in how they can reach you.
You can reach me on my website at www.curvycn.com, on Instagram, curvy_confident and the number one, or on Facebook, Curvy Confident and Nervous.
Now, you put a new flavor to Pretty in Pink.
And
I love your accessories.
Thank
so
you.
Tell us a little bit about the accessories and about your Pretty in Pink.
Well, this is my pre-show outfit. I didn't want to come out and interview on what I'm wearing for the show because we all about making a spectacle tonight. That's what we're here to do. So I just said something soft and pretty, something that I can take off and get back on really fast in case I need to. So just keeping it soft and feminine, really.
All right, I'm going to have to ask you, who did your makeup? Because it is flawless.
I did my makeup.
Oh, wow.
I do that, too. I literally do a lot of different things. So, you know, I just learned as a model transitioning into all these other things that I do, that I just had to become a one-woman team because I'm like, I'm not going to let me down. So I just became a one-woman team, and I pretty much do all of my own styling. I dress myself. I do my own makeup. Wow. Everything I pretty much do by myself.
I'm telling you right now, I'm blown away by
that.
Tell us what you're looking forward to tonight.
I'm looking forward to interacting with the crowd. The people were here, when I say I got here at 3-something and there were people already ready, that doesn't happen often in Cleveland. So to see people just so excited to show up and show out, sold out show. And I always just love getting on a microphone and just having fun. And the models and the whole team have worked so hard for months. I mean, I don't know how Darcy and her team got all of this done. Shout out to us being on our billboard, too. I was on a billboard, too. So it's just great to see all these things kind of come together and you finally get to see what you've been working so hard for. So
come in a little bit closer. I want to keep you in the window. Now, Darcia, I don't know anything about her. I literally woke up today. I was looking forward to watching some NFL football, and the Holy Spirit spoke to me and said, go on your phone and look up fashion shows.
Mm.
And so this came up. I called her. I said, hey, I want to come out. I want to do some red carpet for you. And she was like, where are you coming from? Youngstown, Ohio. And so tell us how important it is to make sacrifices, because a lot of times people don't want to make sacrifices and do things outside the box unless there's compensated for it. But tell us about how doors open for you when you make sacrifices.
It all starts with being humble. I started off doing events just by asking people, can you give me a try? I won't charge you. I just want to get the experience. And the experience that you get doing these things is priceless. You can't put a price on experience, because I've been doing this now for 9 years. And I'm actually glad that you're here, because I was supposed to do red carpet and the show. So thank you for being here. I do red carpet hosting as well. So, I mean, it's just about being humble and taking everything as a learning experience.
Excited. What's the last things you want to say to our audience?
Whistle down. I came up with that. Me and Darcia, we talked about it because she said, I don't know which direction I want to go, but I want to do something that they haven't seen in Cleveland. And when she kept referencing, you know, certain things, I was like, Bridgerton. And I said, but we got to name it something else. So we had so much fun, just all of us going back and forth with different ideas and how we could make this thing happen. So it's really a full circle moment. I'm so excited about the show. I can't wait to go get dressed.
I'm excited too. I'm going to release you, and I'll be seeing you later on.
Alrighty.
Okay, we're still going. You look fabulous. I'm trying to give everybody a different word so I don't give everybody the same thing, but yours was fabulous for tonight. Tell us what your name is.
My name is Cookie. I'm a model from Columbus, Ohio.
So you drove all the way from Columbus, Ohio?
Yes.
That's determination. Tell us how they can reach you, Cookie.
On Instagram is Cookie Wash, fashion model, and then there's also Cookie Wash as well. But if you want to follow the modeling page, it's Cookie Wash fashion model on Instagram.
What do you think about the ambience tonight?
It is amazing, phenomenal, beautiful. I just can't even explain it. There's really not one word. It's not one word.
Now, I know that you hear all the time that you have such a beautiful smile.
Yes.
What can you tell us about confidence and poise?
What I can tell you about confidence and poise is that you definitely need to carry it with you everywhere. You never know who is watching you. No matter when you feel like no one is watching you, someone is watching you. And so that's part of my purpose, is being able to encourage other people, whether it's by voice or what I'm bringing, my presence.
Okay, and lastly, have you ever considered public speaking, because you speak so very well?
Thank you. Yes, I've been asked a few times. So just, it could be a possibility.
Well, Cookie, thank you for your time. And I'm going to look forward to taking pictures of you tonight.
Thank you.
Hey, how you doing?
How are you doing today, sir?
Good.
Come on in a little closer to me. Now, this is amazing. We had somebody that was up a little earlier. He had on a mask too. But this one, it kind of, I've never been to New Orleans, but this is probably what I would expect to see in New Orleans. This is just phenomenal. It's amazing. It's spectacular. Tell us about the design.
So this design, I actually was searching online for a couple different options. I was trying to see something outside the box, but you know me, I try to do something. I actually got this on Amazon, believe it or not, people. So you can look good on a budget. So I was excited to wear it, and I got my hands on it.
Okay, so the first thing I want to say about this is that I can tell that you're an artist. You came out very original tonight. And tell us what you want to do on this evening as far as the pictures, the models, and everything that's going on.
Tonight, my mission is actually to bring life to the designers' designs and actually just make them shine. I know it's not all about us as a model. It's about the clothes, and it's about getting to know your designer and showcasing that. And so I just want to bring that to life and just make sure that their vision is seen no matter what. And so I just want to do all I can do as a model.
Mention okay. Your name. Tell everyone what your name is and how they can contact you on social media.
My name is Robbie, aka Canary. So that is on Instagram. So that's KAN.ERIE_.
What do you think about the energy of the people here tonight?
Oh my gosh, the energy is nothing like I've ever been in before. I would say it's very genuine. It's very from the bottom of your heart. Everybody really wants to be treated like somebody who's special. We all have that desire. We all have that deep in our hearts. And so that's what we wanted to bring out here today in this show. We wanted to make sure that everyone felt elegant and just in the upper echelon.
And it's good to see men on the runway.
Oh, yeah.
God bless you. Have a great evening tonight.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
All right. I'm doing fine. Tell everyone what your name is.
My name is Daige. I go by Daige's Model World on Instagram, D-A-I-J, Models World. Yeah.
Okay, you're just I don't have a lot of light behind my camera, but you're definitely lighting up my camera.
Thank you.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about your personality and some of the things you like to do.
Well, I'm a very silly person. I'm very down to earth. I like to act funny. I don't know if I'm giving that off. I just like to smile. I like to make other people smile. And I just like, and I killed a runway.
Well, you definitely have a fantastic aura.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying?
Thank
so your aura, it just, as soon as you were starting to come to me, everything started to light
thank
up more.
You.
So tell us a little bit about your outfit.
Well, my outfit was styled by Sharp Style Studio. She's actually one of a good friend of mine. She's also a model as well. The corset is her. She styled it, and then she put it on top of one of my green dresses that I had. I actually wore it to prom when I went to high school. So,
high school? Wait a minute. So you're telling me that you haven't picked up a lot of weight like me?
No, you see, I actually fit it better than what I did when I went to high school. So, you know, I got a little bit of weight. You know, I'm filling it out.
Okay, and so I love your hair. I love your makeup. Everything looks nice from head to toe. And I'm sure that you're going to do a phenomenal, tremendous job tonight. Okay, one more thing. How did you find out about this fashion show in Cleveland, Ohio?
So I actually walked for one of the designers before, and she invited me back to do her second annual show. This is actually the second one. So, you know, that made me feel real special because I'm like, oh, I'm getting credibility. Like, you know, she knows I'm a good walker. I'm a hard worker. And she wanted me back, so that made me happy.
And it looks like you love doing a runway and the fashion shows and the whole thing.
It's really fun. I actually started doing this in my free time, so it's like, I started 3 years ago, first of all. So I've been doing modeling for 3 years. I started with one of my good friends that I used to work at a recreation center with. She wanted me to model some of her clothes, and that's how I got into it. It was just like, you know, I was like, oh my goodness, the people here are wonderful. It's so much help. Everybody got each other back, honestly.
Well, thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you this evening.
Thank you.
Tell everyone your name.
My name is Jessica, but everyone calls me Tambourine because my handle is Tambourine Goddess. I used to be a professional tambourine player in a band, so that's where that handle came from.
How tall are you?
Without heels, I'm about 5'9".
5'9", that's excellent New York Fashion Week runway material right there, 5'9". So who got you involved in modeling?
Well, I'm actually a stylist, but I met the creator of the whole production at another event, and she was like, you should come and join and walk and model for me, and I said, why not? So I'm just a social person that likes networking, so I met Darcia, and I was like, okay, because normally I'm a model that models print, or I'm usually the one styling. So the previous model that you talked to, that corset she had on is actually from my personal collection, so I styled all the Victorian pieces that people have on.
Okay, so this is the person right here, because I was blown away by that. And I'm really big on that era, Victorian type of, even the furniture, you know. But the outfits is something that, you know, is just nostalgic, you know, and I love the look. I love the vibe. What inspired you to do that?
I actually also cosplay, so I dress up in comic book characters, anime, video game, but I like to wear steampunk, which is like Victorian steam. So a lot of those costume elements involve having to wear corsets, goggles, different type of masks like the other model had on. So I'm just a creative person that kind of likes music, fashion, art, dancing, writing. So basically being creative as a kid, especially because I grew up in a neighborhood that wasn't savory. So for me, I like fashion and fantasy, and that's kind of like the things I like to marry to each other. So it was a way for me to not get in trouble, because once I got into costuming fashion, I was in the house doing that instead of being out in the streets, because that's a reality basically for poor kids from Cleveland like I am.
Well, the passion is what I just feel coming out of you right now. Where did you get the passion from?
The passion for fashion, I grew up in a Christian household, and the women in my family did not go to church, not dressed to the nines. So my first example of anybody dressing up was like my great-grandmother and my mom. I used to put on my mom clothes and do fashion shows. And then as I got older, I just realized I was good at styling myself and other people. So fashion has just always been a way that I loved expressing myself, pretty much.
Well, I'm going to tell you, like the Bible, where Mordecai said to Hadashai, that we know as Esther, the Lord have chose you for such a time as this.
I definitely agree. I think I definitely relate through people through my fashion, and it's definitely opened a lot of doors, because the event that I was at with Darcia, I actually was dressed kind of like in a nice outfit. So she started talking to me. Clothes make people recognize you before you walk in the room. It's not about vanity. So as a style coach, I'm not interested in telling people to put on expensive clothes or anything like that. I'm interested in bringing out somebody's confidence, because when you walk in a room and you're like, that gives off an air and an aura, it might actually open the door for opportunities. Somebody, like I know a friend of mine, I helped him style his jacket for a presentation, and they end up actually closing the deal, and they were like, where'd you get that jacket with the burgundy? So he wore a gray suit, because in corporate life there's certain things they have to do. But when he took his jacket off, because you have to sit it on a chair, and he turned his back, he had a panel on the back of his jacket that was color. And once they saw that, all the men wanted that. He could have been selling them toothpaste or toilet paper, and it wouldn't have mattered, because his clothes spoke, and he did too. So I think people get to see your presence, and if your presence is exciting, then they want to know more about you. They're like, ooh, who is that?
Well, she gave you a lot of information, which lets me know that she knows a lot about the industry. She knows a lot about what she's doing. She knows a lot about her brand. She knows a lot about people in general, just how they look, how professional they should be, people skills, the whole nine. So thank you for your time, and thanks for sharing the information with everyone today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Tell everyone your name.
My name is Lakeisha.
And where can they find you, Lakeisha?
At the Star 0218 on Instagram.
Now, what are we looking forward to seeing with you this evening?
I'm actually excited to be displaying a couture piece, black and gold, African print. So I'm very excited about that.
So are you one of the designers?
I'm a model.
Okay, so you're going to be wearing that piece. And do you know the history of it, what inspired the designer, and why she chose you?
Well, the one designer that's doing the couture, he's expanding his line to curvy women. So I'm really excited to be one of his first curvy models. But he really is into fashion. He loves, like, he always likes watches. I go to a fitting, he'll watch like fashion shows just to stay up with the trends. But he wears, it's really trendy dresses.
See, I totally assumed. I assumed that it was a female. We have male designers now. Mm-hmm. So tell us the male designer's name.
Daryl Darby. He owns Goddess and Darby.
And I'm sure that you're going to rock the look.
Oh, yeah.
It kind of looks like you're holding on to a secret. Like, you don't want to give it away.
Oh, does it? Yeah. I'll never tell. You just got to watch and see.
Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm here with one of our designers. Tell everyone your name.
Hi, everyone. I'm Natika.
And how can they locate you on social media?
You can find me at The Curve Art on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok.
Now, tonight, it's a lot of star-studded models in here. I definitely had to get some of the designers. And so as a designer, what are they going to look for tonight with your models?
Oh, okay. So we cater to the curvy girl. Most of our items are for curvy girls. So you will see these beautiful, voluptuous ladies coming down in plenty of tulle, plenty of ruffles, plenty of sheer. We got all of that for you. Nothing but sexiness.
Now, what do you look for when you're out and you're scouting for models? What do you look for?
Confidence. That is the biggest key, confidence. I when I choose my models, I want them to be comfortable. I want them to, you know, feel look. I want them to feel good, because when you look good, you feel good. So when I'm picking my models, it's all about confidence. You know, I want them to look good, but I also want them to feel good in it, in their items.
Okay. Your inspiration, does it come from magazines? Does it come from nature? Does it come from TV shows? Where are you getting inspired from?
Oh, you know, I never really thought about that. I would probably say a little bit of everything. You know, TV, as well as because social media is so big, you know, social media, as well as trusting my own instinct.
Now, when it comes to instinct, what would you say is your go-to, like, I have different cameras, and the one I have right now is my go-to camera. What would you say would be your go-to design?
I love dresses. Sexy bodycon dresses. That is probably one of my go-to, or skirts. It's one of my go-to looks for ladies.
Well, I'm excited. I see two male designers over there, and we're going to have them come up. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
How you doing, sir? Come on in, too. Now, I love this outfit. I really love this look. I know you're a designer, but right now you on the other side of the fence as a model. So tell me a little bit about the design you have on.
So this is actually not my design. It's just something I wore today earlier for church. So, but I do have Urban Gear designs. I do have t-shirts, hoodies, joggers, dresses, leggings. Bucket hats and trucker hats, and clear purses and clear book bags as well. So pretty much all Urban Gear.
And tell everyone your name and how they can find you on social media.
My name is Carlos DeMore, and on social media is Carlos DeMore's Creations with two E's.
Now, what do you think about 50 years in hip hop, and how does that tie into you as a designer?
50 years of hip hop? Because hip hop music is tied into Urban Gear. So I like, you know, seeing when you look at rap artists and R&B artists, a lot of them wearing, you know, Urban Gear on stage. So it ties, you know, it brings a tie to them being on stage wearing Urban Gear.
Okay, I've been talking about male designers, and I did interview a male model. How do you convince a model that's a male to go down the runway when he might not feel too comfortable about it?
Just talk to him and tell him, give him some positivity. You know, if he's nervous, just tell him, you know, it'll be okay. I'ma work with you, and just give him some confidence, give him a booster.
Tell us about, like, in the back room, I see people coming out. Tell us what's going on back there with the designers. Let everybody know what's going on, the energy, the camaraderie. What's going on back there?
So back there is we're, you know, talking to the models, making sure everything is right, letting them know, you know, what outfits they're going to be wearing, and making sure that everything is okay, and making sure nobody's nervous and everybody's ready to you know, get on the runway for the big show today.
Okay, I'm gonna throw myself in this interview, and then I'm gonna piggyback off of something you said. I started off in the church, and they kind of frowned on what I'm doing right now. But then the Lord was like, "No, this is what I want you to do." Have you had any similar experiences with God allowing you to do what you want to do, and what you feel that you was called to do?
Well, I haven't had anybody, you know, say anything about me not going into, you know, fashion design. I've actually had a lot of support from family. I have a big family, so I really, you know, family, I probably would be, you know, somewhere else, or not as, you know, as good as I am in trying to grow my business. But with them, with their support, it's, you know, it's really helpful a lot.
Well, I'm going to be praying that God continues to open up doors for you and that he continues to bless you in your endeavors. I can definitely tell by the way that you look that your models are going to look excellent, and I'm looking forward to seeing your design tonight. God bless you.
Thank you. God bless you.
Yes, sir. I'm smiling because I actually love the look. Okay, I love the looks. I love the look. You look like a celebrity out here. Tell us a little bit about your look.
The look I put together is like, I have nothing to do with looking like a celebrity. It's just when I wake up, go out, I just like to look good. I see certain things in the media that I like, and I piece together my own type of style with it. And I came together with this look, and I feel confident. And everybody else be giving me good feedback, so I do appreciate you telling me that you like this look.
The reason why I said that I like the look, because it's like something I've never seen before. And anytime I see something I've never seen before, I know that has a lot to do with that person and their perception of how they want to see themselves and how they want to come across as far as being very artistic.
I try to make sure it's bold, it pops, it screams something new. So if it have all three of those, I feel it's a perfect fit for me and whoever represented me.
Okay, do you have male and female models?
This is my first show, so I do have 3 male models and 7 women models that's walking in my designs. Be different out there and being something that nobody else really seen. My brand is the brand for you.
Tell everyone how they can reach your brand on social media. Your name, your brand, your social media platform.
My name is Devin Scott. You can reach me on social media, Instagram and TikTok at DMar Vernetta. That's DMar Vernetta. If you can't spell it, I'll put it up real quick. Couple seconds. All right. And that's where you can reach me.
Well, you did a fabulous job with the interview, so I'm sure that everything else is going to go over excellent tonight. Have a great time.
My name is Keisha Key.
Now, Keisha, what are you doing for this evening?
I am walking for some wonderful, excellent designers. I am walking for Sisters Unique. I am also walking for Carlos, and I am walking for Curve Vault.
Okay, now, I talked to the first person today, and I told her how the atmosphere is just electric. What do you have to say about the atmosphere and the people that you're coming in contact with tonight?
The atmosphere is wonderful. Very respectful. Everybody around them work together. We work as a team. We are respectful of each other, and we motivate each other. We encourage each other, and we're actually there for each other.
Tell us how everyone can contact you.
You can contact me at keylakeisha@yahoo.com or social media, Lakeisha Key.
And what's going to be the highlight for you tonight?
The highlight is just walking, period. You know, showing off the designs that I have been chosen to walk for.
Well, thank you very much. And our next guest will be coming up.
You're welcome. Thank you.
And tell everyone what your name is, sir.
Hey, my name is Hugh.
And how about you, young lady?
Hi, everyone. I'm Miss K.
Okay, so tell us what you're doing this evening.
I'll be walking for a few different designers, Carlos Damores, Devin Damar Fashion, and a few opening scenes as well tonight.
I definitely love your look. What's the inspiration behind it?
Well, we're kind of trying to stick with the theme, which is Whistle Down, which is, you know, it takes you back to the maybe late 1800s. So that's kind of the theme. I do have another guy with me who wears the same mask, and we're kind of like, you know, a duo.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dynamic duo.
That's right. You got it.
All right. And tell me what you're wearing tonight. It's gorgeous.
Thank you. I am wearing this for our VIP cocktail hour. I am working for a couple of different designs. I'm working for Mr. Daryl Darby. I'm working for Devin Sprint, you know, Devin Vanetta. I'm working for a couple of different other designers, but
Miss Carol as well. We forgot to shout Miss Carol out.
She's a quadruple threat.
Yes, she is. You got that right.
And tell us a little bit more about where they can find you.
Well, you can find me. The best place is Instagram at Hurricane Hugo, Hurricane_Hugo.
And how about you?
My name is Miss K, is MS period underscore, and then K with 3 A's.
Well, I'm going to be definitely looking forward to taking pictures of you all tonight, and have a great show. Thank you for your time. Thank you very much.
So we are here at Whistle Down, an Evolution of Style. This has been a long time coming. We have been working, Darcia and her team have been working since her last show last year. So tell me how you are feeling tonight now that everything is finally happening.
I'm nervous, but I feel good. Everybody is looking good. I'm just excited. I'm ready. I'm ready to see it. I'm ready to see it.
Okay, so a little birdie told me that you are having a little sneak peek of something. What you got going on besides putting together amazing events? You working on something else?
Well, you know, I've been in business for, 6 years, selling plus-size clothes. I had a retail store in Maple Heights, Studio Noel, and I was selling retail clothes. So today, you all get a little sneak peek. I'm doing custom clothes now. I'm sewing. I'm hand-making my clothes now.
So when you start going, don't forget about the little people.
I got you.
Who was there when you was in Maple, girl, because I was there. So I just have to say, this show and us collaborating to this level has been a long time coming, and I'm so excited that we got to share this opportunity together. So what's one thing that you are looking forward to the most tonight?
Really, like everybody else, I want to see the show. I want to see all the designers. I want to see all the hard work kind of like pay off. I'm ready to sit, like, to actually watch it, okay. To watch the show.
I think we are all excited. And one more thing, because I know we have to get rolling, because it's about that time. So Embrace Thy Curves, that is your baby.
Yes.
That is why we are here. Please tell everybody about Embrace Thy Curves, the meaning, the purpose, and how they can stay in contact with you all.
Okay, so Embrace Thy Curves is a nonprofit organization I started last year. We focus on body positivity. My main goal is to bring awareness to self-image and how it affects our mental health. We have monthly mental health support groups that we started. We started our youth fashion camp, and I wanted to do these fashion shows to really help people build their confidence. Last year's show, we had a lot of brand new models who never walked before, and to just see their growth and their confidence, it's good. It just means that this is what I'm doing. I'm here for the right thing. This is my purpose. So I'm glad.
I was just about to ask you if you found your purpose, but it goes without saying. She fell right into it, and we are so excited to bring you Whistle Down, an Evolution of Style, right here at the Mediterranean Party Center, presented by Embrace Thy Curves.
Can I say something?
You can.
Doesn't my lovely host look beautiful? She's beautiful, guys. This is our host, Samantha Walker. So, yeah.
Are you interviewing me now?
Yes. How do you feel today?
I feel good. Anxious, nervous, but nerves is always a good thing for me, because that just makes me want to go out there and work harder and make sure that I'm keeping the crowd going. So I'm just ready to get out there and get this thing moving.
How does it feel to be on the opposite side?
I'm uncomfortable. Like, I'm used to, yeah, I can switch the mic on me, but, you know, I'm Madam Talks a lot, so I'm okay with it.
Y'all are in for a treat. I'm excited. I hope you all are excited. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. It's showtime, people.